was one of the worship leaders. I didn't start till July. So a lot of people who went may not recognize me, and that's totally fine with me. I did day sessions, and then toward the end, I was doing some night sessions. But, you know, I think Lakeland is still alive. I know you have different opinions on that, but I believe that even our lives, our ministry in and of itself, shows that revival happened in Lakeland, and it's still happening.
I actually never went to Lakeland until the very, very end, because I was working. Mm-hmm. But Jason, I mean, he was going since July. I probably didn't go till probably October, right before it ended. And I remember Jason coming back from the meetings and him just being full of, a new authority. And it, like, his ministry changed just within himself. The message that he carried changed. And I saw it change from pretty much one day to the other. It's not because of what happened at Lakeland, not because of Todd, just because of the hunger that Jason had when he was there, the predisposition of his heart to, I just want whatever you have for me, God. And it brought something new in the message that we carry as a ministry and the message that he carries as a leader.
Okay. I mean, like, I had been a part of revival in Brazil for years. And when I went to Lakeland, I was like, wow, I found my tribe. I found my people. So we just did whatever we had to do to be there. And, you know, the message that Todd gave at Lakeland amongst Pastor Strader and Ryan Wyatt and all those that were involved was come and come alive. Come and get what God's releasing and then take it out. So I believe that, in fact, I just met Todd for the first time today. I never even met him there. But I told him, I said, our ministry is fruit. We haven't stopped full-time ministry since then. And not because I met people there. It's because of what was released.
Yeah.
And then as we took it and we've taken it where we go, God's taken us to cities, to crack open cities, to partner with churches.
Go ahead. Now, we've been going to regions of the country, not just a church here and a church there. We've been targeting regions. God's been bringing us to regions to open the heaven over that region and totally do some breakings.
How long does that take?
Takes forever.
The first couple times we build relationships and then, but we keep going back. It's something that needs to be nurtured. Mm-hmm. So
this isn't a sprint. It's a marathon. And it's about building relationships that are long-term. And his dad calls it pickling the nations. It's a process that we link arms and partner with churches and ministries, and then we just keep going back. You know, and we just keep going back and serving the church. This is the life that God's called me to, for us to become this God breed, this new tribe of people who are carrying the message of the gospel of the kingdom. And not just being a part of a shiny lamp with no oil. So I say that to say that it came at that time where I had to make major decisions of which route am I going to walk. And because of the Lakeland Outpouring and being a part of that toward the end, that really skyrocketed us into just traveling full time and going to different regions. So for me, as that part of Lakeland closed, it only opened something new for us that I feel. I'm not going to be one of those that looks at you and said that the Lakeland revival died or that it ended, because I'm still living in what was released. And I think that's important for people to know, that people will say, well, oh, it died or this happened or that happened. Come on.
People's lives were changed.
Yeah.
And that's really what the revival was.
Exactly.
I mean, we know people that were there, that their lives pre-Lakeland were one thing, and after Lakeland their lives are absolutely another, and they're still living proof of that, and that hasn't changed. And the revival isn't just because of a building. It was people's lives actually being changed forever.
I mean, because we're alive, it's still alive. That's how I feel. Because I've heard many opinions. You know, I've heard many opinions, and I've heard many people stand in pulpits. I heard a man stand in a pulpit and say, the Lakeland Revival died. No, it did not. I mean, if there was no one else but us, it's still alive. Because to me, revival happens when a heart comes fully alive to the knowledge of the love of God, and that God is a, you know, that he is love, and that he's violently pursuing us, and then we respond and we violently pursue him, and tell that, you know, tell the person who couldn't walk and then they could walk, or tell the person who was dead and now alive that it's over. No, it's not. That's God's bigger than that, you know.